Well, hey guys, how are you doing today? So the Lord put it on my heart to do a video today. Sorry, I've been a little MIA, but you know, lots of things going on. So just remember that, you know, in the body of Christ, there's times where we all get down and we all feel unsure about things. And it's hard, especially with like spiritual warfare and everything. So, but the good news is that we always have Jesus. When you are a true believer in Jesus Christ, he never leaves you. He's always by your side. So even when you feel like the whole world is just falling around you, remember Jesus is with you. And you know, there's a lot going on right now, just like the Lord told me it would happen. And it is definitely happening. But I do wanna encourage you, because you know, on the 17th, the Lord came over me so strong, the Holy Spirit. And it was something I have never felt before. I could literally see in the spiritual realm. I could see visions of heaven. What else? It was so powerful. I could feel the, literally my body was shaking like I get when I get a message sometimes from the Lord, and I could feel him galloping on his horse. So I know people say, well, you know, that's the end when he comes on the white horse or whatever, but I know the beginning and the end, and Jesus does everything with the beginning and the end. You know, here's something he reminded me of today. So back, I think it was in April, I talked about this. The Lord, my very first prophecy dream of the rapture was 2014. And in my dream, Jesus literally came from the clouds and he towered over me. He was gorgeous. He had beautiful blue eyes, perfect white teeth. I called him like a European model. That is how like gorgeous he was. It's kind of the running joke in the group. But anyway, the peace that I felt in this dream was so amazing. And I didn't feel condemnation from Christ at all. All I did was absolutely feel his love. And when he poured his hands out and we were spinning almost like a merry-go-round, like he was coming to get me for the rapture, in the clouds, it said, follow me and you will go up. Well, he put it in my spirit to let me know that I was singing on the stage at the Greer Festival. Well, in the Greer Festival, when that happened, was August 24th. And August 24th is also the day that I got engaged. And now I'm sitting here in my new apartment, which I know the Lord, everyone says, no, the Lord didn't tell you that. Well, I'm gonna just tell you, Jesus speaks to me personally. Like it's not voices, you know, for the people who say that. It is thoughts of the Holy Spirit convicted. And he'll give me like 90 scriptures after he speaks to me, and they're all on point. Well, he literally picked out the name of my new apartment. He gave me the street, okay, the next day. And what was crazy is I was looking at apartments and stuff, you know, because Daniel and I, we separated. I believe the Lord puts you with people on earth to save them. You know, he has an Adam and Eve for everybody. He has a soulmate for everybody. He doesn't want man to be alone. He always wants them to have a partner. And you know, the Lord has been showing me things. You know, he gave me visions of Daniel's soulmate in heaven, and it wasn't me. And it's hard for people to understand unless they're actually walking in the spirit and they take everything and they ask Jesus. But it's all about the Adam and Eve thing and the stardust equation. What I will tell you is when I went to that apartment, it was the last apartment I looked at with that street. I looked at one in there that was vacant, and the Lord said, no, my child, that's not it. And I was like, okay. So I went to the next one, and in my spirit, this is the one, my child. So then I went to the third one. No, my child, this is not it. That one was cheaper. That one had a better view. And he told me to pick the other one. Well, then when I was like, Lord, why did you tell me to pick this one? Well, come to find out, that was the one that was free for an entire month of rent. So is the Lord clever or what? But regardless, I have no ill will feelings towards anyone. You know, I love Daniel. I love his family. I would never ever want to hurt anybody. You know, I feel like in my spirit, because I'm very strong in Jesus. Like, I live and breathe Jesus every day. I read his word. I listen to his music. I pray to him every day. I literally, every decision I make, the Lord literally cleaned out my closet, guys, because 3 months before, he said, "You can't love me and the world," before he poured his spirit out me and gave me prophecy. So I used to buy things all the time because my sister died and my dad died and I lost 2 babies. And I was constantly getting that hope in the world. And Jesus doesn't want that. He wants you to lay down your world, the desires, and just follow him and pick up his cross. So I've lost it all, you know. I mean, my job, I had to switch jobs, my church, and now the marriage. But, you know, I know everything happens for a reason. And like I said, I don't wish ill upon anyone. And I want those people to be happy. And like I said, it's hard to explain, but I have gotten so many confirmations from Jesus, so many scriptures, things that people do not understand because they're still walking in man's laws. And the Lord showed me Genesis 16. If you're looking into that, you know, when Sarah told him to get with, I can't remember her name, Hagar maybe, to have a baby because, you know, Abraham, or because she couldn't give him one, but she spoke it out to existence. So when you speak things to existence, you know, the Lord, he doesn't need contracts. He has that voice frequency that, you know, speaking into, if you speak divorce or you speak separation into existence, you know, that's done in the Lord's eyes. And you won't understand that if you are walking as a Pharisee. And you won't understand that if you are only focusing on man's laws. And you have to take everything to Jesus, guys, everything. The Lord came over me so strong on the 17th. And I, like I said, and he gave me a message, and I'm not giving the messages to the body of Christ. He just, it's my like personal messages and encouragement. But he, you know, part of it was I'm on the last dimension. He traveled through and he's behind the clouds. I'm telling you guys, I know it sounds crazy, but if you're not watching for Jesus Christ, you are still in this world because he is coming. You know, he told me they're all gonna look foolish when the world goes up in smoke. Guys, do you know when he told me that prophecy? That was like, he's been giving me fire since January. And I think that one was May 23rd when he said that. They will look foolish when the world goes up in smoke. Guys, that is happening right now. There's fires everywhere all over the world. And I'm never gonna say I'm perfect. I'm not. I'm human. I'm not perfect. And I don't always get what the Lord means because the Lord is very complex in his words and how he says things. He speaks in parables and riddles. And I don't always get what he means. And I'll be the first to admit that. But I love Jesus Christ. He come in the flesh. He bled on the cross. He rose on the third day. He was born of a virgin. You know, I used to say he came in the flesh, but then Pharisees said you have to say he come in the flesh. Guys, I will say whatever you want as far as what the Bible speaking. There's different versions. Anyway, I love you, even the ones that condemn. But the Lord, you know, he lets me know what's going to happen before it happens, just like my apartment. And I think we're going to be in a rude for awakening in heaven, you know, when the people who are not totally walking in the spirit right now and not believing him and still relying on the world are going to have to stay for that 12-hour repentance. But the Lord is so good. He will save you. So you call on him. Call on him. It's not too late to call on him. And just remember, he loves us all. And like I said, I wish no ill will for anyone, and I love everybody, even the ones that persecute or condemn. So you guys, ignore the people on YouTube trying to impersonate me, and you know, there's always more to a story. You can't assume things, and you can't condemn your brother and sister when you don't truly understand. God bless. I love you.